Men who ride bikes do not have an increased risk of prostate cancer. However, we have to be very careful with the men who ride bikes. And I'm not just saying just riding your little tricycle down to, you know, the end of the road and getting your mail and coming back. We're talking about the guys who ride basically competitively. And what happens is you got that little tiny seat and your prostate is, guess what? Sitting right on that the whole time. And what happens is that you're pushing down on the perineum and on that prostate. And what happens is you can actually get an inflammatory process in the prostate itself. There is a concern that if you're that guy who rides, make it up, 100 miles a week, that all that pressure against that area and against that prostate is going to cause further inflammation. And we do have a concern that inflammation is going to be one of those predisposing factors which is going to increase a man's risk for prostate cancer. However, it continues to be debated. What we do know is that men who are actually riding bikes, that actually can, that inflammation and that pressure that actually is on that on the prostate itself, it actually can raise that PSA just a little bit. So men who walk into my clinic and I've got a PSA, I ask them a number of different questions. The first question I ask them is, when was the last time they had sex? And or ejaculate, you know, hopefully that's, you know, the same thing. But, you know, if they've ejaculated within the last 24 hours, I will tell them, listen, you know, we need about 24 to 48 hours, you know, go read a cookbook or whatever it's going to take. And then let's repeat this test because I want to make sure that that ejaculation, again, think about that leaky pipe we talked about in previous episodes. We want to make sure that that prostate is nice and rested so we're not actually potentially increasing more of that PSA, which can leak out in the bloodstream. So one is minimize the chance of ejaculation, about 24 to 48 hours. And the second thing is, are you doing anything? Are you riding bikes? It's primarily the road biker guys, you know, that come in. Is can we keep them off the bike for at least a period of time? Usually, and I tell patients about a week maybe, give or take maybe 2 weeks if they're really aggressive riders, a week to 10 days, and then we repeat that. And that way we can get a legitimate PSA and let these guys know is, do we need to investigate whether they could potentially have a focus of cancer? But we try to decrease that inflammation. They have these little bike seats with a little slit down the middle of it. I tell bikers about this all the time, and these competitive guys just look at me and laugh. I mean, you know, hell, I got a tricycle, and I go down to the end of the block, and I pick up my mail. So I'm nowhere near kind of what those guys are. But I'm telling you, you just got to be careful with these things. And inflammation is a potential precursor. Just try to make sure that, again, you're taking care of yourself. And if you are going to get a PSA, you're not doing something crazy. And again, so we can get legitimate tests and we can evaluate you.
Some prostate cancers are high risk, aggressive, and more likely to spread. Others are low risk, least likely to have bad outcomes. The biopsy says cancer, but current diagnostic tools provide limited information about how aggressive a man's individual disease is. So most men decide to treat prostate cancer immediately. Once treated, many men experience serious long-term side effects, like incontinence and sexual impotence. Immediate treatment isn't always needed. But right now, a man can't be sure if his cancer is the kind that is likely to require treatment or if he's okay to wait for now. What if there was a test that could determine how aggressive prostate cancer is? Genomic Health is developing a new test to do just that. By reviewing the underlying biology of the tumor and using genes from multiple biologic pathways, the test can predict the aggressiveness of prostate cancer when diagnosed, allowing a man to make a more informed treatment decision with confidence, taking care of himself with more information and greater peace of mind.